Hey, Mashat, how are you?
Hey, fine. How's everything there?
Good, thank you.
Good.
So, we have been doing online courses since this pandemic started, and the number of our online courses has been increasing due to the lockdown. And how are things? Can you tell me about your lesson plans and your feedback to our students? How's everything going?
So first of all, hey to all people in the house or outside. I hope they are be safe and sound, especially people of Tamadil. So we have started our online courses since this pandemic happened. So we provide the students with some online books, which I'm going to show you. This is the example of what we are doing recently with our students. So we provide them with special books, with the special units and subjects to talk about. So today I want to briefly tell you what we are going to do in our online courses. First of all, we have some, as you can see, we have some pictures here. We have some warm-up questions here, and I can show you with some pens I have here. Yeah, these are warm-up questions. The reason for warm-up question is that, first of all, it prepares you to the subject, for the subject you have to talk about, and also brush up what you have already known about everything you had it before. Then after that, we are going to have some pictures and very short videos. We play them short videos, and this is very interesting. So if you would love to, I can show you some, which is like this. So they watch these videos either with a subtitle or without a subtitle, and they are getting ready to talk about a subject about animals and their relationship with human being. And also they are going to learn a special vocabulary over this subject. Okay, so this is it. We watch the movie. We have some questions to answer in each part. Then again, we have the other opportunity to watch the movie again and go further. So it started with the multiple choices, which is the easiest, then goes to longer questions. Then after that, we give the opportunity to a student to talk about discussion. In this discussion, we actually lead them to the main topic of the book or of the pamphlet or whatever we are giving to them. So here we have preparation to listen. So for preparation, you certainly should know different numbers of vocabulary. So here in the vocabulary, we are talking, we teach them what are the vocabulary, what part of a speech they are, and also put them in a sentence. But the story won't finish here. So my method is that, okay, you learn these vocabularies. Now you are going to put them into your own sentences. So they are going to put them in their own sentences. And after that, we are going to go further. What is the reason of learning of this vocabulary? Because we are going to put them in a listening chart. And also we are going to teach them how to take notes, because most of the students are those who may attend to a seminar or go to a conference. They should know in what way they should take notes. So this chart helps them how to take notes. And we have something more. Here in this chart, we are talking about cons and pros of something. So in this way, if you want to talk about the cons and pros, the contrast of a subject, this chart helps you to provide whatever you want to read or whatever you want to make a speech out of. And the other page is that the end of the listening one of this module is that listening to contrast ideas. We are not going to teach them the whole grammar, because grammar is a bit hard for those who want to talk. We are going to teach them how to talk. If you want to compare two topics together, so how you should put them together, one sentence and contrasting sentence, how do you link them? Here we use them. You say, for example, pros, the cons should be on the contrary. The one should be start with on the contrary, or even though, or however, or yet, or but. So these helps them to improve their speaking. So now you have learned the rule. this is a chance for you here to put your knowledge into practice with these questions. And at the end of the listening one, students should be able to talk about contrasting ideas in any subject. For example, they can talk about detention should be abolished at the school. So what is the good point and what is a bad point at detention? Or for example, all people should be vegetarians. So what is your idea about it? This is a brief thing that we are going to do, and we are doing actually right now in our speaking classes. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and yeah, that's very good. I think the materials and the topics in this book are very interesting, that which is a great advantage for the teacher and for the student, actually.
Exactly.
And also there are some there is some vocabulary chunks which help students
exactly.
to practice is and use them in their daily language.
Exactly.
And also, as far as I know, you also prepare materials according to the student's needs. For
exactly.
instance, if a student's major is, say, architecture or biology or some other in other departments, you also feed them with vocabulary according to their needs, according to
yes.
their areas, right?
Yes, because we have lots of students from different fields of education, and their needs certainly is different. I have a student who is an interior architect. I have a student who says that she needs to get prepared for a seminar or speaking about IT. So these materials are not just good for special for all the people. Also, it's good for special types of people who wants to talk, you know. For example, here we are talking about animals human relationship. Maybe a sociologist, maybe a veterinarian person doctor mm-hmm. needs this subject to talk about, so we help them in this area. And this is just a brief thing, so we have a variety types of topics to talk about, and also listening mm-hmm. and the vocabulary and a bit of sentence structure. This is not grammar. This is sentence structures.
Yes.
We use them in
yes,
our classes.
Definitely.
Yes.
So, yes, I think this gives this is a kind of framework that they can use, and with the help of the vocabulary you teach in their areas, in different areas. For instance, if you're teaching a doctor, let's say you teach the medical words naturally.
Yes.
So that means by using this framework, by using these chunks, and also our student also is able to make sentences in his or her area, right?
Yes, that's so true. And also, this is not just for upper intermediate, pre-intermediate level. We can teach even elementary students how to speak, how to talk. So they don't have to go through a rough way of learning vocabulary with some challenges. They can learn it uh-huh. while they are speaking. So this is our uh-huh. method in our speaking classes, because speaking, most of schools offer speaking classes for pre-intermediate until intermediate and advanced. But even I have elementary student who started learning English with this method, and this method and this chart and this frame helps them and makes the way much easier for them to learn speaking while they are learning some vocab and also sentence structure, sometimes some grammars. That's it. Easy.
Yeah, yes, definitely so. So yeah, it gives them a great opportunity actually, and flexibility opportunity, and these courses help them improve their fluency. That's the best part of our courses. Before we start our courses, we just check our students, we listen to their language learning background and what their level is, and after that they meet you in the online platform and you also have a look at their English speaking levels, and then we decide on the right material and then we start our courses. That's how it works in our institution. So I think this is also a great advantage for our students, because they are this way they can start at the right level. And they see their improvement, they see their progress.
Yes, all true and all correct. I have nothing to add, but these classes are aimed for students and the need what they need and in what purpose they are taking these classes. Some students said that mm-hmm. I just want to travel around the world. So we are gonna work on different tourist attraction parts of the world. Apart from that, we are teaching them how to talk in an airport, how to make a hotel reservation. Or some students say that I have a seminar and I want to talk about economics. So we all tell them different types of charts, and in these different types of tables and charts and diagrams, we are dealing with a new vocabulary and the way of making a presentation. So yes, variety of choices are available in this mm-hmm. chart and this frame. Yes.
That's great. Mashat, thank you very much for your presentation. And I really liked it. It was very clear and satisfying. I really liked it. Thank you very much for your presentation.
Thank you so much.
And hope to see you soon.
Yes. Yeah, I'm thank you for you, and thank you for everything you are providing for people out there, and hope you have a good day and safe and sound. See you
thank
later.
You very much. Yeah, bye bye. Take care. Take care.